Hi guys, this is Vidas, and today I'm going to show you how to improvise a chorale prelude where the chorale melody is placed in the left-hand part in the tenor range, played on a separate registration, solo, manual, and the outer three parts, soprano, alto, and the bass will accompany it. For this, I have chosen Psalm 4 from the Genevan Psalter. And the first step is actually to take a look at the registration. I will be using Rotterdam's St. Lawrence Kirk sample set, the main organ, Markussen, and the sample set was made by Sonus Paradisi, if you want to check it out. So the registration, let's do quite simple. In the pedals, let's add the octave 16 and octave 8 accompanying pedals, the bass line. For the soprano and alto, let's do on the Hauptwerk octave 8 like this, and for the tenor, let's do trumpet 8 in the Rügwerk. Let's check. Yeah, I think this could work. Maybe even a whole pipe to soften a little bit the Rügwerk, whole pipe it. Yeah, could be. So, Hauptwerk, Rügwerk and pedal. Right. Now let's take a look at the first step after that is to play the chorale line in the left hand range with this trumpet. Let's do it. Obviously, in the chorale prelude, this tune will be played twice as slow, and we will change the harmony much more often. So after that, let's harmonize this tune in four parts. Soprano will have the tune now, and then alto, tenor, and the bass will be accompanying voices. I'll be playing with the simple 8-foot principal octave on the Hauptwerk, and accompanying maybe with the pedals too. Once we know the chords, now we can kind of harmonize it the other way, to place the tune in the tenor range. Basically, leave the chords like they are, but switch the tenor with the soprano. In other words, the tune comes to the left hand, but alto stays the same, bass can stay the same. All right, they switch places, everything is the same. They only switch places. And sometimes from the closed position, chord becomes open position. And from the open position, the chord becomes closed position. You will see. All right, let's try. This already sounds quite nice because I have placed the tune in the left hand range, the tenor part on the separate staff, right? So the final step in creating this chorale prelude, in expanding a little bit, is to create maybe a little bit of dialogue and duet between the outer three parts, soprano, alto and the bass, before the chorale phrase enters in the left hand part. And then when it enters, you just keep playing duets and imitations sometimes. And then when the chorale phrase stops, I can pick up the beginning of the next phrase in the accompanying parts, and then play some imitations and dialogues before the second phrase enters in the left hand part, and vice versa. It's basically dialogue between those two colors accompaniment and solo, accompaniment and solo. It's like Buxtehude and Bach would have done in the beginning of the 18th century or end of the 17th century, sort of tenor line, cantus firmus. You could actually place ornamentation in it, but that would be a separate study. I think for now that would be quite enough to play simple long held notes in equal rhythmic values in the left hand part. Let's do it.
Thank you.
So this was kind of a chorale prelude based on the style of Bach, Buxtehude and other German composers at the end of the 17th century, beginning of the 18th century. Basically this is a Baroque style technique, and my left hand played the cantus firmus in the tenor range, one octave lower than it is written in the score, with the trumpet registration on the Rückwerk, and also was accompanied by sweet sounding dialogues and duets between the outer voices, soprano and alto, with the octave 8 registration, and in the bass with the pedals with the 16 and 8 foot principles. So I hope you enjoyed it, and feel free to try this technique in your practice. This really works. It may take some more time to polish each step. We try to do this at least 3 times in a row without mistakes. But basically this is the same technique that I use in my playing. And the more you play, the better you become, right? So thank you guys for watching this video. I hope this was useful to you. Please subscribe to my channel if you want to play me some more of your music, favorite music, or if you want to leave me a comment, what would you like me to play next, or just general feedback would be very nice too. And give it a thumbs up for this video to signal YouTube that it's worth of your attention too. All right, and I'll see you online very soon in the next video. Bye bye.